snow machine is snowing all over the front part of the audience here. Can we get that turkey working? The turkey isn't working, how true that is, but it will. Yes, we have a dwarf up there, ready to turn it on any moment. All it has to do is find the plug. Okay, are you ready to burst into old lang syne? As soon as we hit this tune, I would like to have each and every one of you, whoever you are, whatever you are, turn to the person next to you and show them some sort of bizarre gesture of goodwill. Because if there's one way that 1974 should go out the window,
I'm I'm a gentleman, I'm so precious. Come on, did someone go to place only this business? Just a sleeping man.
Thank you. tastes like honey, honey. Get ready for Christmas, it's honey, honey. Every time you put your lips down there, just honey, honey. All you gotta do is smell his mouth.
$10,000 worth of damage.
What?
The world just stopped over and I just finished squirting a fountain pen up a wee-wee and everything. And
what?
I'm hungry. Listen, don't let any of that fool you because, see, us English pop stars are so far out and everything. We do this stuff all the time. I know that you here in the colonies are so dumb and retarded and everything. You can't possibly comprehend our activities, you know, but...
Yeah.
Listen, I'm really hungry.
You mean you want something to eat? You want something to eat after all that?
Sure.
Listen,
sure, we English have to eat too.
I know just what you want.
It's not oatmeal all the time.
I know just what you want.
Wow. Do you know what I want?
Yes, I bet you don't know what I want.
I bet you I might.
How about some kitty cat?
about some kitty cat du jour?
Kitty cat du jour, yeah. Well, listen, that sounds really good, but along with that, I would like to get something more substantial, something that would nourish an English person's body. You know how thin we are.
Beans. We got some beans. Beans will stick to you.
You listen, no problem. The last time Noel Redding was through here, he told me about something that he ate that really helped him a lot, you know? He told me he came to this very same hotel. This is the Chateau Marmont.
This is the Chateau Marmont. Do the room service.
Okay, look. Will you please send me one green hawker?
One green hawker? What else would you like?
Yeah, I want a green hawker and a greyhound locker.
And a greyhound locker. This is strange.
You didn't think I knew about the Greyhound bus lines being from England and everything. You know, we have those big red ones.
Oh, I see. Okay, well, if you want it, we'll send it up. I mean, we're here to please. The Chateau Marmont.
Yeah, the Chateau Marmont.
We're here to please. What else would you like on that?
Well,
lots of whipped cream.
Sure.
Lots of cream to whip.
Green locker and a Greyhound locker.
Green locker and a Greyhound locker.
A little whipped cream and a little
cream.
Smoking.
Smoking.
And the Pygmy Twylyte.
Smoking and the Pygmy Twylyte. No problem.
Okay. And also, I would like to have a crystal eye.
One crystal eye.
And another crystal eye.
One more crystal eye. Two crystal eyes.
And a crystal kidney.
And one crystal kidney. Would you like it wet or dry?
Hey, let's see. Let's have it wet tonight.
Wet tonight. All right. Would you like anything?
We'll have kidney a la Ruth.
Kidney a
la... The television set, the girl in the room and everything. Will you please send it up right away with your fastest man?
We'll send it up so fast by a gentleman who's normally used to going slow. By the time he can go fast. So in the old days, they used to call him Oliver Hardy. But nowadays, they call him Big Mac. Big Mac. Big Mac. Big Mac.
The essence of the main events of 1974. The name of this song is That Arrogant Dick, Nixon.
Thank you.
Georgia. We're going to shuffle out right now the one and only Great Legs, who will assist us in the performance of two entirely new songs which you have never heard before. Somewhat appropriate to the present situation.
I already did. I'm
in
here,
Dinah-Moe. You'll hear
Dinah-Moe.
I'm just pulling.
Hope it's fine.
San Ber'dino.
I'm
subject up, but this is a song about the Depression. And I don't mean the last one.
Thank you.
gonna check our tuning again so we don't sound rancid for the rest of the set. And then we'll do Dinah-Moe Humm. Actually, you know, we should perform this song after another thing that we normally do in the show. Would it be okay if you waited a little while for us to do that? It would be more entertaining that way. Okay, we're going to rethink our scheduling here, ladies and gentlemen, and start off with something that she won't like this, of course, but it features Big Ruth. The name of this song is RDNZL. This is for lovers only. Saying, smell my beard? Thank you. You just can't do it.
Get you in the bed for the sisters. A little bit dumb, you can prove it every time. All in was gone. I don't mind that she called me a bum, but I knew right away she was really good at it. So I got down to it. I ripped up a blues and stood in my thumb and a black road to another sugar plum. My wrist got numb, and I still didn't hear no Dinah-Moe Humm. No Dinah-Moe Humm.
Each in his own way,
here on New Year's 1975, would start the year off with a wonderful teenage pseudo squirt off right here in the middle of the Long Beach Arena. So, all you have to do, am I making myself clear? All you have to do is to pretend to how you say in your language. In the middle of this little boogie vamp that we're gonna play in here. And if any of you actually do happen to in the middle of this boogie vamp that we're gonna play here, we have some napkins that we can pass out to you later. So
don't be shy.
Don't be timid.
Set yourselves free, y'all.
Get down.
Good God, ain't it funky now?
Squirt off right in the middle of the arena.
We won't watch.
Thank you. stereo was always hard, and I just love it in a song. But I was born to have adventure, so I just followed up the steps, right past the dooming incense tender, to where she hung a castanet. She stripped away her rancid poncho and made out naked by the door. We did it till we were unconscious, and it was useless anymore. She had a stick for a roulette, and she was beating it work, but she wasn't done yet. She had paper skin, a mouth with a pin. I told her she was alright, but I put it on her.
Fire. a small tiny horse. His name is Richard Nixon, and he's a good horse. Even though he's been thinking to stop him and sound for blankets on anyway. He's been thinking to stop him and sound for blankets on anyway.
I'm gonna find me a horse just about this big and ride that sucker all along the borderline with a swift and crusty tweezers in my hand.
He'll be the wrangler with me.
Mighty by myself, I wouldn't have no cause, cause I'd be raising my for the push. Me and the pygmy pony, Ribba-Babba-Bingo Claws push. And then I might just shoot back down and ride like a cowboy into the trunk of my timer.
Move it to Montana, so
move it to your tongue, yeah.
Move it to Montana, so
move it to your
tongue,
yeah.
Move it to Montana.
Purposes is not a pair of finger cymbals. Yes, I was right, it's a tambourine. Now George, as you know, George Duke is from the jazz world, and a lot of the people that come from the jazz world are certainly down and funky, and the tambourine is a symbol of ultimate downness and funkiness, as applied to George Duke, is right on, brothers and sisters, if you get my drift. Now, George is going to play the tambourine for a few moments here. He's going to whip him and you into a veritable jazz world frenzy. And in the middle of it, he's going to pretend to hurt his finger. And then he's going to do it again.
Christmas tree.
Hurt it some more, George. And then after he's hurt his hand to the point where it's all twisted and gnarled and weird, he's going to play jazz.
Picture a dark night. Picture a dark night. Like the night. It was after the gig.
Anyway, I was sitting next to Monty Perellis.
began getting strange vibrations from the waitress.
Dun, dun, dun.
I said, "Are you in love?" She said, he said, "Not yet, but I'm working on it." I should have gone up to the room, but I was afraid the faggot was gonna get me.
and Pickles was up there taking care of business. I see. Me and Tom were sitting on the couch looking at each other and saying, damn, what is this shit? I said, I'm getting out of here.
And so we went back to the hotel. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. lead vocals, Chester Thompson on drums, Tom Fowler on bass, George Duke on keyboard. Thank you very much for coming to the concert tonight. Hope you enjoyed it.
Thank you.
watching my TV. Been checking out the news till my eyeballs fail to see. I mean to say that every day is just another rotten mess, and you know it is. And when it's gonna change, my friend, is anybody's guess.
There's no way to delay that.
is, without a doubt, the end of our program for tonight. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you weren't too uncomfortable standing around out there for however long you've been doing it. Sorry the snow machine didn't work, but you know, there's always one enormous chump out at every concert. Once again, and for the last time, ladies and gentlemen, Ruth Underwood on percussion. Napoleon Murphy Brock on Genesis Newbolder. Chester Thompson on drums. Tom Fowler on bass. George Duke on keyboards. Bob Duffy on guitar. Ladies and gentlemen, top of the evening to you.